All right, today is two tick stop loss, 40 tick target today because I can do it. 888 at 801. I could go long at 77, right at the high here. If it can break through and go up to pivot. Pivot is at right at 52.97. So if it makes a nice little run up, we should be able to at least get to break even on it. Very tight range this morning. We have this 52.55 to 52.93. That's super, super tight. What doesn't make sense sometimes is why the economic report didn't come out. And they're waiting until March 10th to release the unemployment rate and all that good stuff. So wait until a week after to release this. Normally, the first Friday of a month is the big, big Friday. But it's not actually happening until next week on actually my birthday, Friday, March 10th. Happy birthday to me. Unemployment rate. I'll be out of FTP at that point, though, and I've never been underfunded that quick. So looking at next week, I'm hoping that by March 7th I can apply to go back into funded, and then hopefully no later than the 21st of March I should be trading my funded account by then, I'm hoping. That's the goal, at least. I've seen it take as long as 2 weeks to get in and out. With the red bars here, I'm looking at a long setup right now, going for the pivot point. With only I'm only risking two ticks here. Monday I'll probably just risk one, but I thought I'd give it a little bit of trying to find a point that I think it would go to and then go up through, maybe 75. Go up here to 75 and then it'll keep moving. Yeah. 76 looks like a point that it might be able. It gets through right through there. It might. And I'm just doing this because I'm playing with a two tick stop. Call 1-800-220-1810. And a trained case manager will confidentially guide you through the free local service. See if it can run up here. In actuality, what we have is a tiebreaker scenario that got busted. This was the tiebreaker, 626 and 708. And the tiebreaker came in on this bar right here, 801. So we are in a tiebreaker scenario. And so 76 could be a good point to be in, or we wait for confirmation. Ideally, you want to be in about 78. If I was really looking at this and give myself today, I'd risk 7 to 8 ticks on the trade. That's where I'd find value, about 78, 79 to come in long. What I'm hoping for, though, is the market will fill me right here at the 76 mark and not look back. forced the market to come back up over the 200 bar SMA on the tick chart. Obviously, it could be a very quick trade. You could come in and boom, run me right out. Normally, on a day like today, if I wasn't qualifying for FTP, I would be risking 7-8 ticks today based upon a two-thirds stop. Eight would be my stop. Now, I like the long over the short because pivot point has not been penetrated. So I still think we're close enough to pivot that we could run to pivot. Pivot's at 97 today. It's really close. Sitting right there. We've been up there twice this morning. If you go back and look at your charts, you'll see that we've been up that far two times a day. Right here, 2:40 in the morning. And once again, we've been up there at 7:15 now. Is that right? Is that 5 minutes? Yeah, it's a 5 minute chart. Looks pretty nasty. So a run back up to here again and up. This looks really nasty because it's a very tight range. Look at that. 58 to 93. What's that? I guess the open was back here, but 55 to 93. Really, really super duper tight range. Here's the 5 minute right at 72. It's selling off right now. Now the S1 is located at 52.13. Switch up the music today. I feel like listening to. I'm going to remove the open order for now. Kind of. Looks like 74 is the order now. Thank you. All right, we're going to get lucky enough to stay in this one. P targets of 40 ticks profit target. One and a half P is what that's what we need today for break even decision. Might as well only risk one tick now. We got in, so let's see if we can just risk the entry point pretty much and see if we can stay in this. If I was going to trade this, ideally I would want today, it would be 8 ticks. So 74, was that 66? I've either come out at 67 or 65, not on an even number. looking for the market to get at least a pivot. It's called pivot point magnetism, right? By the way, we've kind of moved into another fake out. I mean, here's your 888. We got in, and if I wasn't in, we'd be in what's called a tiebreaker again. So look at your tiebreaker futures tips here. We're in what's called a tiebreaker scenario now. So you'd stand aside. You wouldn't reverse off of this. Usually you wouldn't reverse off of this because you're in a tiebreaker and you'd be waiting to see which way the market wants to go right now. But we're in, so we'll see. You know, I don't like putting in that stop, but 65, I would go with the 65 stop. I would make it get lower. So if I was not qualifying for the FTP right now, I don't have to go after. I've already beat it. So I don't really care about what this trade will do. Pride says I want this one to win. But if I was in the trade itself, I'd risk 9 ticks here because of this. I'd risk make sure the market would force me out because it went down underneath here. And actually, in actuality, this is probably a good short position to be in. If I was going to reverse, if it came down to 65, I'd probably want to run it down short. So this would be a failure at pivot, third time today. So if I was going to trade this day, I would be sitting with a reversal signal underneath here. Get a quote at 724-537-5161. I'll just take break even on it. Granted, I wouldn't be at break even on this trade if I would be sitting down here at 65. You know, it's kind of difficult to say what you would do, but this, we haven't run a 1P target yet. 1P target is 87, so we need to get up to here. to fill at the minimum to go to break even. Need to be up there for break even. I would just hold this, get a one tick win. Three peak target, by the way, that I'm looking for is 53.14. Interesting. There's the only trend line that I kept on the charts today from yesterday. Very fascinating. When I find a key point, I usually leave it on. So I left that on there yesterday. For some strange reason, I left that on. If you remember, I believe that was where we were having some issues at the 16 mark. You were in the room. I kind of remember a little bit. And then finally we went through it for the fourth time. And we went up to the 50% retracement line and it sold off. So we're telling the market if it gets underneath here, we want out. Now, it's actually a very good low-risk trade right now. I might have done this myself now. Especially now that we've come back here, I would probably protect right there at the 75 mark. Because now I'm thinking if we don't break out, we're going down. So let's remove this now. And I would be protecting the 75, 74 break even now on what I see in front of me. And it's Friday, so Friday, you can throw all your rules out the window. Things will do crazy stuff. What goes up comes down. Gravity rules do not apply. Normal rules of gravity do not apply on a Friday. Plus, we would be in a tiebreaker scenario anyway. So, inside a trading range. That's all we've done so far. You're sitting inside a trading range. We defined the trading range. This is what I did right now. We broke out of it, that trading range, but then we have this up here, right? So we busted out of it right through here. So if we look at this logically speaking, what do we got in front of us? We have this, this, this back here, and now we have this and this, so we can see that. I mean, there's traders that believe if it doesn't move right away, it's best to move towards break even right away, because more trades work out right away. So there's a theory out there that goes with, you know, that, and the break even scenario kicks in, then you just look for a better area to enter the trade later on if there isn't an area. What I would want right now, though, if it runs me out, which probably it looks like it's going to, we just got knocked out. But I'd want to see the tiebreaker scenario now. So now I need a bar to be higher than 888 to get back in. It doesn't matter what color the bar is, but I have 888 versus 870, and the difference between those two bars is 18. So to get excited about wanting to get in this market, I would want to see a higher volume bar than what that is. And then that would get me excited about trading again. So, hey, how about that? Put our net out $7, $6.32, day 9. So let me just screen print this. And since I'm in such a great, good position, you know, it's a 65 would be the area that you'd want it to break through. It's probably where I, you know, with us not ever getting to 1P today, I would be more than, I would easily risk that. All right, so 30 minutes, that's my end of my trading day. That's it. That's all I have to do for the day on day 9. I'm out. That's all I can tell you right now. I'm out. So I don't know how I would handle it. What I can tell you is, what the hell is that? What I can tell you is, that I probably would have stayed down here and forced the market to make a new low for him to come in. Or I might be at 67, 68, who knows where I'd be. I might even come up to here at 70, 69, right in that area. Force the market to go down to 69. This would have been, market would have had to at least move to here for me to feel more comfortable about being at break even. But like I said, I'm in pretty much get what the market will give me and move on mode. So this was day 9. I mean, I'm just taking a one tick hit or two tick hit, and I'll do the same thing on Monday of next week. And then well, this is the end of day 9, and I'm sitting 16-18, so I just need to be above 1500 at the end of by day 10. So I'm there, I'm already accomplished this goal, so all I gotta do is not F up right now, and then I move to funded, then I get paid. So don't F up an FTP once you make your goal. Bam, that's what I recommend. You get your goal, one tick stop or a two tick stop with going after a 3P target. That's pretty much what I do, or a 1P target. Whatever you decide is fine, but you know, don't give up the ghost and don't be stupid because you've already made it. So you're good. Tell you what, there's a ton of commercials on Pandora. That's it. That's all there is to it on a Friday. Maybe I don't know what I'll do with this one video. I'll render it though, and then I'll put it up. So y'all have a great weekend. If I was trading this, it's hard to say what I'd do. You know, if this was day one, I'd risk 65. I'd risk 65, and I'd be looking for the pivot point to get run, at least right now. This is also works as a kind of a triple top, but the other side of this is I have a tiebreaker. So I sometimes I do get out at break even if I don't like what the market shows me. So you know, it's hard to say exactly what I would do with this, but I can tell you this. What I would tell you is this: is that I wouldn't be any higher, probably force the market to come down to 66 now and knock me out, or 67. I wouldn't be at 65. I would say if the market goes to 67, it's going through this low, and then I would short the market underneath this. I would take a short underneath the lows here because this will be a failure bar, and then we're heading down lower. That's kind of how I'd handle it, but all things being said, you know, I really, you know, the pivot point has been my the target, looking for that 5314 bust through this area here, then I would probably short it from there. All right. I don't know how it'll finish up today, but that's all I have to say about today's trading. We need to obviously get through this 82 mark right now to have a shot at running pivot. Y'all have a great rest of your day. I'm out of here. God bless. Take care. I'll see you on the next time I put a video up. Bye now. All right. No sooner did I hit that stop button, it went up to pivot. So I do want to recover this. Since we're at pivot, I would protect the 1P profit area on this particular trade now. So I would definitely protect here, or I would be protecting break even. And we talked about this level up here. So that is the 3P target. On a Friday, I'd be more than happy to grab 3P on a trade. So maybe we'll hang out for a minute or two and see what happens. The 2P target, by the way, 5301. So on a day like today, anything over 2P is a win. Guys, I would be happy right now just to knock out a 1P target on this particular trade, just in case it fails at pivot today. And we made it to 1.5 too, by the way, which would have been our break-even decision at the 98 line, or 94 today. So 94 is the break-even decision right there. So no sooner did I turn off the video than it shot right up. And you can see our tiebreaker now is to be short. So let me go over that in just a second. So with this volume bar right there, reversal would be 94. I would short at 93. So I'm short now. So I would take my gains using this bar right here. This is the tiebreaker. This bar breaks the tiebreaker scenario. I would risk the highs up here. So I'd risk the 5301 line. And I would give up some of the gain. So we would get 94 today. That would be 20. And we're risking 93 to 01. We're risking 8 ticks. And now I'd look for the market to make new lows. This is how I would have traded this particular. I would have come out. Now I'm going to pause this video and I'll tell you how this trade finishes up. So, but that's what I would have done. I would have got out here. I would have been out and reversed here at the 93 based upon this bar right there. This is highest volume bar. This is your tiebreaker. 3009, that's your tiebreaker. Now I'm looking for the market to go straight down through the lows. I'll let you know how things work out a little bit later today. Okay, a few minutes later and we're still hanging out here. This is still a nice pattern though to be on the short side, and we're pretty much risking our gains right now, right? We had basically 20 ticks of wins if you would have followed this. And then we are short at 93, and then we would see, actually I'm looking for the markets to make new lows, and I would want the market, my bottom target right now would be 5148. That would be where I would set my actually let's pop that number in there. What was it, 5293? Yeah, not still. So there's 12 range of 5132. So who knows if it gets it, 5148. But I would settle in at 5253 and be more than happy to get that or 66 on the short. So we'll see how this trade finishes up a little bit later today. All right, so as we close out today, the short trade did not work out. It made a new high as it went up. So this bar right here ends up becoming a failure bar, but you know, it's Friday, and I would caution against, once you're proven that something's not going to work, it's best to stand aside until you see maybe even a higher volume bar, or if you do attempt it, just only attempt it one more time and then go. Today it would have been not a wise decision to go against this, even though we saw this, and still the market just basically decided that it wanted to go up. So you know, and this is Friday for you, and like I talked about, Friday's decision making can obviously be where you would say, hey, wait a minute, if I continued in this trading day knowing what I know and all this failure coming in here, something's up, right? So here's your GAN signal coming across. Obviously, I've got hindsight working for me, but I just want to show you this. One, two, three, fourth time up. So this would have been my Bugs Bunny trade right here. Right in this area, if I wanted to get long and I would wait for it to cross over the pivot, and then I would have been in the long. So one, two, three. This did not cross over pivot. This was the fourth time through over pivot. And that would have been a great spot to go in what I would call Bugs Bunny. So we can't beat them, join them. So in the original, remember, original entry was actually to be long. Then we had we had this, right? We had long signal, then we had the tiebreaker, and then we had this, which made me want to be short. And then we had the failure of the short. So eventually we end up with what's called the Bugs Bunny. So if it's not going to go down, therefore, perhaps it wants to go up. It's Friday. I couldn't tell you if I would have waited an hour and 37 minutes for me to catch this. I just don't know. But what I can say is that, like I talked about previously, Friday's gravity rules don't apply. You can go back and just see Friday after Friday after Friday, the weird things kind of come up and happen. So here's your double bottom of this, right, of that swing, confirming and holding. And then, like I said, hindsight's always easy to figure out. In hindsight, you can say, wow, if I just would have got in here, I could have reached all the way up to here. And it's amazing, went to 5333. You know, that's a level that I know the market likes to go to. We've been 5333. I can't tell you how many times we've been at 5333 inside this trading range that we've been in since December 3rd. Eventually, we're going to break out of it and we're going to move out. But we have been inside this trading range. Now, this is the third month that we're going into the same arena, right? All of December, all of January, all of February, and we're actually working in this point would be our fourth month inside this trading range. And 5333, 5337, those are levels that have been stopping points. So, hey, eventually we're going to break out of the trading range and we'll go from there. So I just wanted to share this video and I'll put it up, probably put it up on the blog a little bit later today when I feel like rendering and getting it all together for you. So have a great weekend. For my own personal trading, all I did was take that one tick win today and move on past day 9. And on Monday will be my trading day 10, March 6th. And then I'll be out of FTP and going back into funded. All right. I'll talk to you later. God bless. Take care. I'll see you on our next video that I put together. Bye for now.